Ho, ho, ho. And what would you like for Christmas, little large man?
Hey, Santa, I'd like to have my mortgage paid for.
Ho, ho. Not sure the elves can make that happen.
Wishing for a Christmas mortgage miracle? Patriot Trading Group wants to make your wish come true. Just enter to win on Family Values Radio website, and you can enjoy your mortgage paid for all of 2020. That's right. It's the Christmas Mortgage Miracle Contest, where if you win, you'll have all kinds of extra money the entire year. For a vacation, new clothes, new giant screen TV with whole home audio, whatever else may be on your wish list, because the winner will receive their mortgage or rent payments covered for all of 2020. To enter, go to Family Values Radio 1010. And click on the banner. Enter once each day to increase your chances to win and look for bonus entry opportunities. That's Family Values Radio 1010.com. And enter the Christmas Mortgage Miracle Contest, sponsored by Patriot Trading Group. Contest ends December 20th. See our website for details.
Hey, good morning and welcome to Monday. I'm Joe Jaquin, CEO of the Patriot Trading Group, and I guess it's Happy daylight savings time. Yes, everybody, we now doesn't affect Arizona, but everybody else moved the clocks. I think they moved them backwards. Yes, we went back in time. The worst thing ever, not a big fan of daylight savings. I want to apologize to everybody on Friday. We have been, I will say that we have spent a ton of time trying to get ready at 1360, the KHNC up in Colorado. Jason, me, Brian, Bernice, we've been working really hard. And then Jason had an emergency. He had to go to see the dentist, right? And let's face it, nobody likes doing that either, right? Going to see the dentist. Yeah, no thanks, right? IRS audit, go to the dentist. I mean, it's pretty close. And this was an emergency. You know, he had to get it done, so you knew it was going to not be a good visit on Friday. And then we had some issues in the control room there. I know that up until about 8 o'clock, in Colorado, we had various different issues. I'm going to say that really, obviously, A, sorry about it, but B, it was the most simplest thing. And it took us forever to find it because, you know, and I guess back in the day when we were an agricultural type society, maybe it had value. But again, you know, all the equipment today's got lights on it, right? I get it, right? When you didn't have light and you know, you didn't, the tractor was oxen, right? The flashlight didn't exist and, you know, headlights and all that. We got lights now. So, a bunch of states are saying, hey, man, let's get rid of this. Because it does. I know TV, radio, a lot of different things, even in the workplace. You know, people got to get up an hour earlier or an hour later, and it just wreaks havoc with you, you know, with the body because you get into these routines. I wonder where they think Arizona would fall. If they got rid of it, would we be Pacific or would we be Mountain? I don't know. I'd like Mountain, I don't know that. Then maybe it's because the station in Colorado's on Mountain time. It'd be easier for me. But my vote is let's be Mountain time. But right now we're on Mountain time. I think, right? Yeah, we're on Mountain time right now. So, but either way. Hopefully, in my lifetime, daylight savings time will come to an end, caused us all kinds of problems, and it really didn't. We actually did a pretty good job, except for one button that took us 3 days to figure out. 800-951-0592, that is the toll-free number to the Patriot Trading Group. the website at allamericangold.com, and we got so many things to talk about. The trade deal, right? More good news. I'm gonna update you on that. We're making progress there. Wilbur Ross was out today. Someone dusted that guy off. Talking about Huawei. Looks like we're gonna all forgiven possibly with Huawei, right? Oh, you stole our stuff. You spy on people. It's all forgiven. We do the same thing. I'll update you there. We weren't on the air. We'll talk a little bit about the jobs number, but the jobs number was decent. You know, one of the things that they're talking about is how, like, black unemployment's at an all-time low, Mexican unemployment all-time low, all the minorities, Eskimo, Native Indian, Asian, right? You name it. Everything's all-time low. Why wouldn't more people be like, you know what, maybe we should vote for Trump? I'm just saying, right? You think about all the big inner cities and all those things. If those numbers are true, which, you know, we can argue and debate, but I want to believe that it is. But if that more of them wouldn't be like, you know what, I'm tired. You know what, I'm tired of someone giving me something, because it doesn't seem to be working. The other way seems to work better. When I go and work for something, it works better. And then big news today, coming up, Max Keiser on what is coming with China, and I'll talk about that as well. But Max Keiser, big news now. This would be a huge game changer. If he's right, talking about China, gold, cryptocurrency, and the dollar. I mean, you think about it, that's a pretty big net that Max Keiser has put out. We'll play him coming up here in the next segment. Remember, talking about what China's really up to. So we're sitting here talking about this trade deal and no deal deal. Where are they going to meet? Is it going to be in Iowa somewhere else? China may be playing a totally different game. Patriot Radio News Hour. We'll be back right after the break. I know we should probably be Pacific time, but doing anything that California does, yeah, I'm not interested. So let's if we have to have a choice, I say let's be mountain time, even though it probably makes more sense to be Pacific, but that's California time, and I want no part of that. I mean, what a disaster that state is. I mean, between the no power, the fires, and the ridiculous policies, no thanks. But having said that, big news all over the place. You know, and I've said this for a while about the trade talks, right? It's not about trade. Nobody cared. I mean, we may have cared, right? Workers in Ohio, in Michigan, in Pennsylvania, in Indiana, right? They may have cared, right? The Rust Belt, right? Syracuse, New York, my hometown, which I'm going to tell you right now, devastated. It's horrible what they've done to these cities. You know, you think about where I grew up in Syracuse and Rochester and Buffalo. All of them really the same. The only business there are colleges, right, and government. Colleges and government, and then all the great-paying factory jobs. They weren't great-paying, but they were blue-collar-paying jobs. They're all gone. They're all gone, and now you just got people that either work for the government or live off of the government, one or the other, and hardly anything else in between. But we were still okay with it. And again, not me, but we didn't care that China made all the cheap crap. Heck, we didn't care that they made the expensive stuff. We only cared when we realized, oh, wait a minute. China wants to write the rules. I don't even think they cared that they stole stuff. It was when China started to compete against the United States with the rest of the world. Hey, you want 5G? Hey, we'll give you 5G. Sure. Yeah, we'll do it for less too. Right? Hey, we can build aircraft carriers and missiles and bombs and stealth airplanes, right? We can build all that stuff now, right? I mean, we stole it all, or they gave it to us. Either way, we can do it now. And now all of a sudden we have a problem. And of course, I've been saying it all along. This is about global supremacy. This is about China coming to the center stage and saying the world has a new superpower, right? Let's not forget, right? China makes and sells more cars than anybody in the world, right? They use more steel, more copper, more cement, more oil than anybody in the world. They're the largest trading partner with the majority of the countries throughout the world. They're here. For years, people have been speculating about why it is that China and Russia, and really, now let's face it, let's call it what it is, the vast majority of the rest of the world has been buying gold. And China comes out every month and they say, oh, we bought 10 tons or we bought 15 tons or we bought 5 tons and we've got about 2,000 tons, right? Russia says, hey, we got a little more. We got about 2,200 tons. And, of course, I sit there and I think about, you know, China, the largest gold producer in the world. And it's really not very close. They produce about 400 to 425 metric tons of gold every year. China is also the largest importer of gold in the world. So you think about it. Okay, wait a minute. They produce more gold than anybody. And they also import more gold than everybody. They import over 1,000 metric tons of gold a year. So you're thinking about just China alone, somewhere in the neighborhood of around 1,500 metric tons of gold a year, all the way up to possibly 2,000, depending on how much central bank buying they're owning up to. Of course, India does about 1,000 metric tons. They're the number two importer of gold in the world. And a lot of people are saying that China has been lying about their official gold holdings. And I look at it, and I'm one of those guys. I don't see the math, right? I'm like, okay, they're the largest producer. And now they import the largest importer of gold. Where's all that gold going? That's a lot of gold. And is it possible that China has a lot more gold than what they're saying? A lot of people have speculated. Max Kaiser, for those of you that know that name, I know a lot of you listeners, you know Max Kaiser. A lot of you probably follow him. He's a podcaster, pretty big at it, big cryptocurrency, Bitcoin guy. He was out with a huge announcement over the weekend. We're just going to play a small part of it. Ramon, play Max Kaiser.
Everyone knows you as the ultimate Bitcoin guy, but you are still in precious metals, so still make the case for gold and silver here. despite those numbers.
Well, like I said, you know, the repo market is flashing financial catastrophe. And the reason it's flashing this and telegraphing, you know, markets are discounting mechanisms. They tend to be price sensitive to events that are not necessarily seen or known until they actually happen. And what's happening is that China is getting ready to open the trap door on the U.S. dollar. Here's what I'm hearing, Daniela. China is about to announce that they, in fact, have not just under 2,000 tons of gold, but closer to 20,000 tons of gold on a very aggressive move to put the final nail into the U.S. dollar.
What's your source for that?
As you know, we do our show that's broadcast globally, and we have a lot of contacts all over Asia and in Eurasia and naturally in Russia. And the feeling is that this is the time for China to now step out and put to rest this idea of censoring their global trade,
right,
with the U.S., censoring SWIFT and other things that they do to curtail China and other countries, because China's making their big move, the big move for the 21st century. They're going to pull the trapdoor. And let me just add that they're also, as has been reported by the media, rolling out a cryptocurrency. A lot of the details have not been divulged. I can tell you that that cryptocurrency China's rolling out will be backed by gold. It's a two-prong announcement. Number one,
okay,
China's got 20,000 tons of gold. Number two, we're rolling out a crypto coin backed by gold, and the dollar is toast. The dollar's going, like every other paper money in history, to zero. And you say, where's gold going? Is it going to 5,000, to 10,000? It doesn't matter. In dollar terms, gold is going to infinity. In dollar terms, Bitcoin is going to infinity because the dollar is going to zero, like every piece of garbage fiat money before it.
Wow. China has got 20,000 metric tons of gold. That, you know, we always talk about currency devaluations and they're going to lop off zeros. Apparently, according to Kaiser, China has been omitting a zero. You know, they'll just, oh, it was a fat finger mistake. Did we say 2,000? Oh, we meant 20,000. And then he talked about China and cryptocurrencies. And there was a big, big announcement last week coming out of China about just that, that they're going to be launching their own crypto. Kaiser says gold-backed. Man, it makes sense, right? That fits. When we sat there, we talked about for years, hey, we need to be your own central bank. Remember, I'd say it all the time, be your own central bank. Why are all these central banks bringing their gold back home? Gold that had left their country 100 years ago. Hey, you store it for us. Don't, yeah, it's there. You great. You know what? 100 years. You know what? Nah, never mind. Give it back to us. Not to mention now all these countries adding to gold. Oh, Germany, the latest last week, right? Germany add first time. I've been doing this 16 years. That Germany has added to its gold holdings in decades. So the Kaiser announcement that China's getting ready, what did he call it? The trap door on the dollar, and getting ready to launch a gold-backed cryptocurrency, and that the dollar's done. Listen, well, all fiat money goes to zero. We know it's about timing. So now I'm going to talk about it. I pulled this article. I've been waiting to talk about it. Today is the day. This was China just, by the way, this was out of the Business Times, in case you wanted to know where the source is coming from. China launched a crackdown on cryptocurrencies like a month ago. A lot of you remember Bitcoin was, what, down and below 8,000 because of the crackdown that China had launched. And then about, I don't know, we'll say 2 weeks ago, maybe a week ago, 10 days ago, China made an announcement that it's going to introduce its own digital currency. And again, I've been telling you this for a long time. These central banks, they deny it. They're all looking at it. They're all not, and what I mean, I'm not talking about they're looking at it. They're all working on it. Canada's working on it. The United States is working on it. Europe's working on it. Asia's working on it. Everybody is working on it. One that would allow the government and the central bank to see what people spend their money on, according to analysts. That's one flaw. But let's get to what it is that China was talking about. They're saying that China's e-cash system will tightly regulate all aspects of spending run by the People's Bank of China, which is obviously the Chinese central bank. It will give the PBOC greater insights into transactions throughout the country. In late September, Chinese central bank governor said China's new currency may be associated with existing electronic payment systems, such as the popular WeChat and Alipay phone apps. So like Alibaba, right? These are China's answers to Apple and Amazon and all of those things, which are widespread and allows yuan transactions through bank accounts. While he gave no timetable, Chinese media is now putting their money on a November 11th launch. So that's a week. That's 1 week away. On a November 11th launch to coincide with Singles Day. That's the, by the way, that is China's shoe chopping day. Singles Day, it's like Amazon Prime Day, right? Whatever that Amazon Prime Day is, and I've never done it, that. My wife's the Amazon shopper, but it is the largest single shopping day of the year in the world. Would be November 11th this year, China's Singles Day. When we get back, I'll tell you some more details now coming out about China's new cryptocurrency and, according to Max Kaiser, gold-backed.
This is the Phyllis Schlafly Report, presenting a daily conservative pro-family perspective since 1983 and continuing the legacy of Phyllis Schlafly. Now, from the Phyllis Schlafly Center Studios, Ed Martin.
You'd think the people in the District of Columbia would love the Constitution more than anyone else. Not only is D.C. the seat of our national government, but the very document itself is housed right there in the National Archives. They have more reason than anybody to be proud of the rich heritage of our U.S. Constitution. Despite all of this, D.C. has gained a reputation as a lawless enclave where the very spirit of the Constitution is constantly under threat. Now, the overpaid mayor, delegate to Congress, and other officials in D.C. are using our federal taxpayer dollars to try to overturn the very provision that created Washington, D.C. H.R. 51 is a bill to make the District of Columbia the 51st state. You won't be surprised to hear it was introduced on the first day of the new Democrat-controlled Congress by D.C. non-voting delegate Eleanor Holmes Norton. Elijah Cummings' House Oversight and Reform Committee has already heard testimony from Mayor Muriel Bowser and other D.C. officials. The partisan purpose of this move is to give Democrats in Congress two new liberal senators and one new seat in the House. The District of Columbia cast 93% of its votes for Hillary Clinton in 2016 and only 4% for Trump. To put that into perspective, keep in mind that Maxine Waters' district in California gave Clinton less than 80% of the vote. It's obvious the Democratic Party would ensure that only very liberal politicians would represent D.C. in Congress. The decision to put our national government in its own separate territory, outside the boundaries of any single state, was one of the pivotal compromises essential to reaching agreement at the Philadelphia Convention in 1787. James Madison foresaw the dangers of giving the swamp power when he wrote in Federalist No. 43 that it was a, quote, indispensable necessity, end quote, to prevent U.S. government officials from becoming dependent on local residents who would wield too much influence over them. Don't let our Constitution be trampled by agenda-driven liberals. For the integrity of our national institutions to survive, we must make sure there is never statehood for the swamp.
This has been the Phyllis Schlafly Report from Phyllis Schlafly Eagles. In 2016, the conservative movement lost one of our strongest leaders, but Mrs. Schlafly's work and her voice continue through this radio program, our work in Washington, and the influence you have in your own community. Be part of that legacy at phyllisschlafly.com. We encourage you to bookmark phyllisschlafly.com and join us again for the Phyllis Schlafly Report.
Scholar, blue collar of a man. He came from the school where you didn't eat nothing if you couldn't make it with your own two hands. He was backwoods, backwards, use words like no sir, yes ma'am, by God be darned.
Wow, what an announcement. Of course, nobody's paying attention, right? Well, what do we care about? Oh, the McDonald's CEO who's single has had a consensual relationship with a single female that also works for McDonald's. Oh, he's got to be fired, right? How horrible. The trade deal thing, and again, we kind of know what's happening there too, don't we? Yeah, we're not really going to get a whole lot. We'll get something, right? China will pretend to do something. They talk about that, and oh, the Fed's never going to raise rates again, and we don't care about repo markets, and you know, China and us, you know, we're talking all the time now. I wonder if they know. But don't worry, our central bank isn't unprepared. I'd love to tell you that they were, you know, because they're morons, in my opinion. They're when you take them and listen to what they say, if it was a test, okay, and the answers that they're giving the answers to the test questions, their grade would be an F, right? Listen, you need to repeat this grade, right? And the problem is they'd be failing it year after year. But that's all by design. They don't care that it's right or wrong. They want to tell you, hey, it's going to be, what's their answer every time? It's going to be fine. It's okay. Don't worry. There's no inflation. It's okay. Don't worry. There's no inflation. We've got tools in the toolkit. Oh, those tools didn't work. Well, don't worry. It's okay. There's no inflation, and we'll just create more tools in the toolkit. Oh, wait, those tools didn't work. Oh, don't worry. It's okay. Right? And we create these bubbles, and we talked about it last week, right? The P.E. ratios of the stock market again, just, you know, like today we got a record, right? Another record, and they're small records, but still records are records. It's a good thing. But not all records are created equal, right? What happens to the record books when somebody gets caught for steroids? What happens? Oh, they get stripped, right? Oh, that doesn't count, right? Remove them from the record books. Well, that's exactly what we got here. We got we're in the steroid era of fiat money that is getting ready, as Max Kaiser said, hey, China's getting ready to open the trap door. So here's what we know. The Chinese central bank is on record that they are definitely going to launch a cryptocurrency. That part we know. What we don't know, right, is it going to be backed by gold? Most people, and forget about Max Keiser, most people think that is the case, right? This is why they've been buying all the gold. And this is why Russia's been buying the gold, right, and all these other countries buying gold, because their central bankers are like, hey, by the way, China's going to be wanting us to pay this way, so we better get our house in order, so to speak. Then we don't know when. Right now, people are speculating, hey, this December 11th, the biggest shopping day of the year, is a good starting place. I don't know. Right? I would be like, maybe not start on that day, right? Get the sales and let's do it like the day after, right? Or maybe it's the day before. Work out some of the kinks. But here's what they're saying. Blockchain technology or another technology that evolves from the existing electronic payments that are currently set up. And it's a blockchain, right? Call it what you want. We're talking about blockchain. It is likely to be more akin to the thing called electronic money, stored on a physical medium that has a cryptocurrency such as a Bitcoin, which is based on a computer network, right? Some warehouse in, I don't know, Beijing, right? They will adhere to centralized management. In other words, the Communist Party is fully in charge. Right, and this really makes sense, and it's something where, you know, we worry about it here in the U.S. Right, the government can just say, "Hey, you can't buy that anymore." Just make it impossible to do it. Right? Nope, can't pay for it. Blocked. Right? Of course, it'll create a black market. You ought to trade something physical for something. Its purpose is to replace cash. China, which was once the stronghold of Bitcoin. Just 2 years ago, three major Chinese Bitcoin platforms accounted for more than 98% of all the world trades. But those sectors were unregulated. Of course, that is no longer the case today. And Beijing shut down the trading platforms completely in 2017. And this is the thing that I worry about with Bitcoin. Or any of the others. I love them. Yeah, they're great. But with a stroke of a pen, the government does what it wants. And it's just too easy to say, hey, we're shutting it down. Thank you. Way to work it all out for us. And we're going to take over now. In a country where social credit systems and facial recognition cameras are so widespread, the new Chinese cryptocurrency could allow the government to more closely monitor the actions of its population. I look at it. Look at Hong Kong, right? Remember, China is like, hey, no more face masks, right? They're going to ban them. Well, with a cryptocurrency, you could do it. You could ban all sales of face masks, scarves, right? Halloween costumes, you name it, ban them all. Its purpose is to replace cash. The digital currency will allow the People's Bank of China to collect all kinds of information that was, impossible with transactions through paper currency. China's move coincides with Facebook's plan to launch, of course, the Facebook one. That may be dead on arrival there. But Libra, they're still saying that Libra system is supposed to roll out next year. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. But this is kind of the latest. Nonetheless, many analysts expect more and more transactions around the world to move online. And don't be surprised, right? This would make sense to me. China wants to be first. Patriot Radio News Hour. We'll be back after the break. today, U.S. $5 liberties. So these are going to be the older ones, the older coins, 1866 to 1907. Think about this. If you had one, I don't know, 1900, so 119 years ago today, it was worth $5. And if you had $5 in your wallet, in your pocket, in 1900, you had a lot of money. And that was take care of your whole family all week long. Food, right? Clothing, whatever it may be. I mean, $5 bought stuff back then. Of course, think about it today, $5. Right? I mean, if $5 fell out of your pocket today, I mean, would you be like, man, would you be annoyed? Yeah, a little bit. Are you going to be like the whole world? Oh, no, I lost $5. No. But just to tell you how the path of where the dollar is headed today, I've got them on special, and I mean, I've really got them heated up today. $400 for a U.S. $5 Liberty gold piece. You're saving $25 a coin at 800-951-0592. Think about Friday. You know, Friday we had a good jobs number. And I don't want to be too critical, but all the jobs were crap. I mean, they were all in restaurant, right? The bartender, waitress, right? Paper, plastic. You want fries with that job that we've seen for most of the decade in bedpan changers there in the old folks' home really were the majority of it all. But neither here nor there. The debt. Another big jump. So last Thursday, I was like, hey, we're $70, $75 billion away from $23 trillion. We hit that Friday. So we hit 23. Matter of fact, I think right now we're at $23 trillion, $15 billion in the national debt. So, you really see what's really happening out there. By the way, if you took the last 8 months, just the last 8 months, the federal government has gone into debt $1 trillion in 8 months. $1 trillion in just 8 months. Three lines, two lines open. U.S. $5 liberties, 800-951-0592. Max Kaiser, the news of the day, says China has been missing a zero on their gold holdings and says they actually have 20,000 metric tons. I don't know, right? He's way more connected over there than I am. I don't know if that's possible, but I guess it could be. And just tells you the fraud that is in the precious metals markets. But the real big news is they're going digital. They're going crypto. It's going to be gold-backed. This is the backdoor to the dollar. You know, and I'm sitting there watching these trade negotiations going back and forth. And Max Kaiser talking about the trapdoor on the dollar. Is this China's ace in the hole? Are they going to be first? And are they coming out with a gold-backed currency? We'll have to wait and see. 800-951-0592. U.S. $5 liberties down at $400. Great fractional gold right now. You think about it, fractional material, and you're not even paying $25 over spot for them. You know, you think about it, at $1,600, gold's at $1,510. That's only $90. Four coins, you're paying like $22.50 over spot on a $5 Liberty. What a great opportunity. 800-951-0592. I've been very critical of the Dow and the S&P, the NASDAQ. And, I like profits, right? And if you do the math, and I'm not talking about the fake math and the adjusted earnings. I'm talking about what companies actually report as true profit and loss, you know, under generally accepted accounting principles. Earnings haven't moved in 5 years. And yet the Dow's up, what, 10,000 points? Right? You're thinking, man, that's a lot of points. You know, we're only at 27,000. That's a lot of extra PE built in. Morgan Stanley over the weekend sent in a message to its investors saying that don't expect anything near these returns that you've seen over the next 10 years. The next decade could be a dismal one for both the stocks and the bond markets, according to Morgan Stanley. And I'm telling you right now, the reason they're saying that is they looked at where Japan is, you know, because we're kind of on, let's face it, we're on the Japan model now. $23 trillion worth of debt we're spending now. Federal government spending is $1 trillion in 8 months and rising, right? $1 trillion and rising. I like, hey, we crescendoed and it's going down. No, it's $1 trillion and rising. They say that traditional investor portfolios, which make up 60% of stocks and 40% of bonds, will return just 4.1% over the next 10 years. That'll be the lowest rolling 10-year period in the past 20 years. Think about it, even worse than the crash. Patriot Radio News Hour, final segment coming up. Final segment here, Patriot Radio News Hour on a Daylight Savings Day, Monday. The Morgan Stanley now saying this is going to be the lowest returns. I just looked it up. It would be the lowest returns since the 1950s, according to to Morgan Stanley. All of it based on all the stuff the Fed's done, right? We got super high valuations. They pulled it all forward. It was great for people that were close to retirement, really bad environment for savers. All of it's going to catch up. Max Keiser says China's getting ready to announce their true gold holdings, and it's going to be more like 20,000 metric tons, and a digital-backed gold currency is coming from the Chinese. But the Dow's up 100 points. Because they're talking, hey, you know, we're still talking about that phase one deal. Go figure. By the way, we did get one piece of economic data out. Factory orders down 0.6% in September. I don't know how that's good news, but before we leave, real quick, as we're going out, Ramon, play Max Keiser. If you missed it when we played it earlier, here was Max Keiser, his big announcement today.
Everyone knows you as the ultimate Bitcoin guy, but you are still in precious metals, so still make the case for gold and silver here. Despite those numbers.
Well, like I said, you know, the repo market is flashing financial catastrophe. And the reason it's flashing this and telegraphing, you know, markets are discounting mechanisms. They tend to be price sensitive to events that are not necessarily seen or known until they actually happen. And what's happening is that China is getting ready to open the trap door on the U.S. dollar. Here's what I'm hearing, Daniela. China is about to announce that they, in fact, have not just under 2,000 tons of gold, but closer to 20,000 tons of gold on a very aggressive move to put the final nail into the U.S. dollar.
What's your source for that?
As you know, we do our show that's broadcast globally, and we have a lot of contacts all over Asia and in Eurasia and naturally in Russia. And the feeling is that this is the time for China to now step out and put to rest this idea of censoring their global trade,
right,
with the U.S. censoring SWIFT and other things that they do to curtail China and other countries, because China's making their big move, the big move for the 21st century. They're going to pull the trapdoor. And let me just add that they're also, as has been reported by the media, rolling out a cryptocurrency. A lot of the details have not been divulged. I can tell you that that cryptocurrency China's rolling out will be backed by gold. It's a two-prong announcement. Number one,
okay,
China's got 20,000 tons of gold. Number two, we're rolling out a crypto coin backed by gold, and the dollar is toast. The dollar's going, like every other paper money in history, to zero. And you say, where's gold going? Is it going to 5,000, to 10,000? It doesn't matter. In dollar terms, gold is going to infinity. In dollar terms, Bitcoin is going to infinity because the dollar is going to zero, like every piece of garbage fiat money before it.
Wow. And you know, it's hard to argue. The facts definitely do line up. Right now, gold is down a dollar, if you can believe it or not. Down a dollar on the news, $1,511. Silver just above $18 to the ounce this morning. U.S. $5 Liberty gold pieces at $400 or $22.50 over spot at 800-951-0592. Patriot Radio News Hour. We'll be back tomorrow. Eric's going to be joining us, so stay tuned for that.
Ho, ho, and what would you like for Christmas, little large man?
Hey, Santa, I'd like to have my mortgage paid for.
Not sure the elves can make that happen.
Wishing for a Christmas mortgage miracle? Patriot Trading Group wants to make your wish come true. Just enter to win on Family Values Radio website, and you can enjoy your mortgage paid for all of 2020. That's right. It's the Christmas Mortgage Miracle Contest, where if you win, you'll have all kinds of extra money the entire year. For a vacation, new clothes, new giant screen TV with whole home audio, whatever else may be on your wish list, because the winner will receive their mortgage or rent payments covered for all of 2020. To enter, go to Family Values Radio 1010. And click on the banner. Enter once each day to increase your chances to win. And look for bonus entry opportunities. That's Family Values Radio 1010.com. And enter the Christmas Mortgage Miracle Contest, sponsored by Patriot Trading Group. Contest ends December 20th. See our website for details.